Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to understand how to add an add event listener to your JavaScript project. So the first thing that we are going to know here is how to add an event listener. This is the first thing. In the second case, we are going to learn how to use named function with the add event listener. And in the third case, we are going to use different functions within our add event listener. So let's get back to our project. And here, just beneath this form, we are now creating a button inside. This is the first thing which is required. There goes the button. And within this button, the first thing we are creating the ID of this button, which should be click me. This is the name which is provided. And inside this button, we are going to say here, click me. This is the thing that will be displayed. Now, in the second case, we have to create a JavaScript here. And inside this script tag, we are now going to add an event listener. Now, within these first brackets, we are going to insert the parameters of addEventlistener object. So the first thing is the name of the event. This is the first thing that we are going to provide here. So what should be the name of the event? It should be click. And another thing, whenever you are declaring an addEventlistener, just move out the on word from everything that you have learned from our previous tutorial. That means on mouse over will be referred here as mouse over. On click will be referred here on click, and on mouse out will be referred here as mouse out. So this is the first thing that we need to specify the event as the first parameter, as the first parameter of this add event listener. And in the second case, we need to declare a function. We are stating that document.getElementById. Now we have created a getElementById, but we haven't provided any ID name over here. So all we need to do, we need to provide an ID name for say para. So all we now need to do, we need to create the same ID within our body tag. Now we have created a paragraph tag and we are naming it, we are IDing it as para, and we don't need to provide any kind of text into this. So anything written over here should be observed over here. Now let's get back to our project and reloading, and we can see that a click now button is produced over here. Now if we click here, we can see that hello world has been created. Now here comes the anomaly. If we click anywhere onto this document, we can see that hello world text still appears. Reload. So the question is, why such anomaly? We have specified that on clicking this document, this add event listener will be attached, but this is not the exact thing that we are intending to. We wanted here that on clicking this particular button with an ID click me, that means here's the element, on clicking this click me button, then this text, then only this text will appear. But instead, whenever we are clicking anywhere on the document, we can see that the text is now appearing. So in case if we want to make some changes over here, all we need to do, we need to copy this thing and we need to paste it here. Now if we get back to our project and reload, first of all we are clicking into this document, anywhere into this document, and we can see that there's nothing over here. No text, no such text hello world is generated into your document. But if we now click into this particular element button, then we can see that this hello world is now appearing. That means we have successfully attached this add event listener method to this particular element, which is known as click me and which is ID'd as click underscore me. So this is the first case. Now in the second case, all we are going to do, we are now going to name this function. For say, we are naming this function as, now we, you can see that we are first copying this thing. No, not copying, just cut it and remove all those sort of things here. So we can see that a click me addEventlistener has been created, which has two parameters. The first one is the event name and the second one is the function name. Now beneath this, all we are going to do, we are going to now define it function click here. We have to put this inner.html. So now it is completed. If we now get back to our project and reload, clicking on it, and we can see that hello, this is now using named function. That means we are now using this named function over here, which is stating as click here. And you may observe here that the just only the name is being provided, no such kind of parameter declaration, nothing is provided over here, only the name of the function is being provided. And then this name is defined here, and inside we can create anything that we want. So this is the second case, and in the third case now we will be now using two or more functions into this addEventlistener methods. So we are now trying to do something else over here. So first of all, we will be creating another button which will be termed as so we have created a button here, place it, create some additional spacing, there we go, and in the same manner we are creating a p tag. Here we have created a button with an id demo. So in this case, so this is the first event listener that is being added. This is a click event, and this should be mouse out event. Now all we have to do, we have to define all these three individual functions, change this function name here, now we need to define all these three functions as we have told you. So in the first case, we are providing here as and we are copying it thrice, just creating all those things, copying it and pasting it. Name, copy this paragraph ID and paste it inside. Now if we just get back to our project and reload, we can see that a click on the button option has been produced, and we can see that on mouse hovering, the mouse over here, sorry, we have made a mistake, I think it is not mouse over here, it is mouse hovered here. Now if we just get back to our project and reload, and we can see that on mouse hovering, the following text is now appearing, mouse hovered here. Now if we click here, we can see that mouse clicked here, this text is now appearing, and on mouse out condition we can see that mouse is now out and it has been stated into your bottom paragraph clearly. You can use any number of events with this addEventlistener. It has nothing to do with it, and once you can name your function, you can use it anywhere into your JavaScript project, and you can create your own user defined function to manifest several purposes. So that's it for today's tutorial. Hope you guys have liked this tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.
Thank you.